Let's chat.
If you're a member of the Tennessee Aquarium, and if you're not, here's a reason why you ought to be. It is Tom Benson here to talk about Shark Week. Tom, good morning.
Hey, Chip.
Ty, why did I not get a tie like this? Look at this tie. It's got nothing but sharks on it.
That's right. Well, this is a vintage Shark Week tie.
A vintage Shark Week tie.
We used to have these in the Tennessee Aquarium gift shop, and we don't have this particular one, but it is a fun tie, and I only get to break it out like once a year.
I understand.
During Shark Week.
Hey, sharks are probably one of the most misunderstood animals, and you guys at the Tennessee Aquarium are doing a lot to correct that. Yeah. You got some really cool events coming up here for aquarium members. Only.
Right. So Shark Fest is this Friday from 5 to 8 p.m. and we really try to shark it up a lot.
Sure.
During Shark Fest to, you know, one, highlight these animals. There's 440 some species. Some people would argue there's up to 500. Mm-hmm. And in fact, just a week ago, there was a new species that was identified in the Gulf of Mexico. They were doing some research in 2010 and they brought up a lot of deep animals. They were actually looking at sperm whale feeding behavior.
Right.
So deep in the Gulf of Mexico. And one of the specimens that was caught in a trawl was a 5.5-inch what they call pocket shark. There's only been two pocket sharks that have ever been identified, a different species in the North Pacific Ocean and one in the Gulf of Mexico.
Wow.
And they're called pocket sharks because they have these little pockets around their gills that actually squirts out a glow-in-the-dark liquid.
Is it a self-defense mechanism?
It is, and also to attract prey because down in the deep ocean, when something's glowing, everything's going to kind of come over and be attracted to it. So they can use that to escape, but they can also use it to attract their food. So we're learning things about sharks all the time, and this is an opportunity to kind of celebrate sharks for the role that they play in the oceans and the fact that they are declining rapidly and they need our protection.
And they should be treated with respect. Invariably, this time of year, you hear stories about shark attacks. And if you look at the percentage of people who go out into the oceans versus the number of people who actually have an encounter with a shark, the number's awfully low.
Very, very low. In fact, globally, the entire world, 6 billion people, only 4 are killed by sharks every year. So you have more chances of having a vending machine falling over on top of you as you're getting a can of soda in the morning than you are from being attacked by sharks. But I think one of the things that happens, Chip, is technology has allowed us to see more sharks because people have cell phones at the beach. So if there's a fin going past and people document that, drones, just the other day, I saw some great drone footage on Facebook from Australia where two guys were actually filming sea lions, and here comes this great white shark that was just offshore. Those animals are probably out there all the time, but we see more of them because more people are out there with technology capturing these images.
They certainly are very beautiful, majestic creatures, and you're going to be able to find out a whole lot more about them at the aquarium coming up this Friday. It says here, Tom, that visitors will be able to sink their teeth into shark-infused ice cream.
Yes.
I dare ask how you infuse ice cream with sharks.
Well, but Clumpy's ice cream is going to provide the ice cream, and we have gummy sharks that we'll put on top
Gummy sharks.
Gummy sharks. There'll be face painting and all kinds of fun things for kids.
I'm glad you clarified that. And this is something that is going to be really cool, and this is sort of a break, if you will, from what you typically see at the aquarium because you're so species-focused on the sharks, on the shark species. I think it's going to be something absolutely fabulous. We had a piece of video just a moment ago, and I wonder if we could loop that again and get you to explain to us where this was shot and in what context.
Okay. Yeah, so this is right inside the Secret Reef exhibit. It's the big ocean exhibit that we have that models the Flower Garden Banks National Marine Sanctuaries in the Gulf of Mexico. So the two species, the big sharks that we have in that exhibit, are the sandbar and sand tiger sharks. And the sandbar is this one right here that has kind of that more classic look of the shark, very sleek, has that big prominent dorsal fin. And the sand tiger shark is the one that has that bad dental work. It's the one that you want to send to the orthodontist because it has those raggedy teeth in front of it. They're gorgeous ambassadors for their species, and we're so grateful to have those right here in downtown Chattanooga where people can come up and get close to them. But on Shark Fest night, you'll get to talk to our experts about them. We'll have two special dive shows, and then a lot of people love to see the sharks eat.
Sure.
And so we'll have a special feeding that will happen at the end of Shark Fest, which is very popular with our guests. And a lot of people don't realize that we have target trained these sharks to eat from a pole from the surface of the water. So they get a piece of fish that's put onto a pole. It's lowered down into the water, and the sharks actually just take that right off the pole and swim away with the chunk of fish in their mouth.
See, there are a number of reasons why you and your family should join to become members of the aquarium if you're not already. You can find out exactly how to do that by checking out the website, which is tnaqua.org. Again, tnaqua.org. And don't forget, it is Shark Night coming up Friday.